Assalamu alaikum. Today we will talk about duration types. What are the duration types in Primavera P6? Let's check here in general tab. While you are in activities, I created a new activity and duration type is here. So you have four types of durations: fixed duration on units, fixed duration on unit time, fixed units on time. So what does that mean? Let me highlight something important. We are talking about duration, okay? So the main impact on what we are doing here is the definition of the duration time. How much time are you going to do for this activity? Okay, now we schedule by time with no resource sometimes, and sometimes with resources. Now, if we are scheduling by time without no resources, whatever you do here, it doesn't impact you at all, because you are the one who is defining the time. You control it. If you are not adding resources, whatever you choose here doesn't matter. Okay. Number two, if you are working with resources, now this duration type become very important. Okay. So I created this activity. Let's go to the resources. And let's check this bulldozer. And it has a calendar of 10 hours per day for 6 days a week. And productivity of 400 cubic meter per day. Okay. And let's assign this dozer to this activity, which has also a calendar of 10 hours per day for 6 weeks. Let's go to resources, add resources, and let's choose this dozer in. Okay, now the dozer is in already here. Okay, and automatically the original duration is 4 here. We put it 4. Okay, and let's see the impacts of what we are doing here as soon as we change the things. Now, let me explain to you first what we are talking about. Now, the factors we are talking about here are the budgeted units, the budgeted unit per time, and the duration. Okay? Now, the first option is in the duration types, fixed duration and units. So the budgeted unit is fixed and the duration is fixed. So the duration here will not change because you are adding it. And the budgeted unit is available and you need to define the unit time for it. So for example, for a dozer or bulldozer whose productivity is 400 cubic meter per day, that means in 5 days it will produce 2000. Now here the units are known as 2000, but if I put it 8000, it means I will need four dozers to complete this activity in 5 days. So it will be 4 dozers multiply equal 4 dozers multiply by 400, the productivity per 1 dozer, multiply by 5 days duration equal 8000 cubic meter, which is the budgeted unit here. So even I have the budgeted unit time here as 400 per 1, now because I need to finish in 5 days, I need to add the dozer 4 times. So the budgeted unit per time here will be 1600. I can bot 1600 for one, of course this is multiplied because I changed, but this is not true. I can bot in front of the dowser 1600, but it's not true because the productivity for the dowser is 400 per day. I should add four dowsers, okay, with the same productivity. So let's go and apply this in this activity. Now this is the activity. Let me first copy it and just paste it here. Please don't change anything. Yes, and again paste it, please. Yes. Oh, sorry. Okay, and paste it here. Okay, if you notice here, it's already pushing the activities away because the dozer is leveling. I think the leveling open. Yes, it's open. So resource leveling is open. So it pushed the activities out completely. Okay. So there is no parallel work for the dozer. It is there in the same time. It can't work in the same time. So now I remove the resource leveling and it returns back all of them to be done in the same time. Okay. Now, of course, we can't do it in the same time with the same resource, if you know, but this is just for this example. Now let's change this one to fixed duration and units. Okay. Now in this one we have duration fixed, budgeted units are 1600 because the duration is 4 and the productivity is unit per day is 400. So it automatically tell us the budgeted unit to be done here is for 1600. This is the normal calculation, the correct calculation. Now if the budget is 2000, if the budget is 2000 here, if I change this 1600 to 2000, let's see what changes. Nothing. I didn't extend the time. Okay, I didn't extend the duration because the duration here is fixed. Okay, similarly in this one, okay, it calculates automatically 1600 cubic meter per day as a budgeted unit. If I change it to 2000, nothing changed. Now, here we come for the third one. If I change this to fixed units and change the duration unit, and notice the change, please, to 2000. Now, it changed the duration to 5 days. Okay? Now, the unit time is still considered fixed. Okay? So it tells us with one machine, you need to finish this job in 5 days. With one machine, you should finish 2000 cubic meter in 5 days. So we use fixed units when we are having full information about the machines and the units to give us the right duration. We use this in earthworks, we use it in everything actually. Actually, this is the way how we should calculate schedules and bot schedules in the right way if we have the right knowledge to do scheduling by resources. This is the right way to do the work because duration defined by resources. Here we define the resources and we manipulate in the we fix the duration and manipulate the resources. Let's go to number four. Now, similar to number three, because we are fixing the unit time, okay, which is here, which means we have to increase the resources, okay? Now, if I do here 8,000, for example, it extended to 20 days because there is one machine to do the job. Although it said fixed unit times here, we still can't change it, okay? But this is an indication that it's no go to change the number of resources. The resources are limited, and this is their devolve time units, unit time, and the devolve time and the maximum unit time. You can't change the resources. This is the only resource you have. And you know that you will finish in 20 days. Here, you might have more resources and you can work around it and deliver faster if you include more resources. Here it tells you with one resource, you finish in 5 days. You might change the dozer and bring it a bigger one, which finish 500 per day and will return back to 4 days. So here I change the type of resources from a dozer with 400 cubic meter per day to 500 cubic meter per day, and it gives me the same duration. Here, it's the same resource. It's the dozer with 400 cubic meter per day, no change. You can't add the 500. You can't, because for example, allocation limits, there's no space for it. It can't maneuver in the area. The size of the dozer and the size of the machine will be influencing your productivity by location limits. So that's it. This is the productivity you have. So here you use fixed unit time, and it will extend you to do in 20 days. But here you have the freedom to change the resources and make it more productive if you want, or add more resources also. You can double the resources. If you have, for example, here units 8,000, it goes to 20 days using one dozer. I say, no, I will use two dozers, 400 per day. I add for them 800, or I keep 400 and I add the same resource again, okay, with the same duration here, 4,000, the unit, the budgeted unit, and here 4,000 to 10 days. And if I want to 10 days, make it 5, I add another one and another one. You understand? So here we have to add resources to get the duration in fixed unit and fixed unit time. However, here the duration will be fixed all the time, whatever you do for the resources. But the productivity will change based on the budgeted units. So, for example, if I add here productivity per day, it tell me you will do 1600. Okay, so that's it. If you add another one, if you add another dozer, and you see here is 800, and here is 800, okay, it tell you the productivity of the machines are less than what you do. And here you know that these resources are not full productive and their efficiency rate is 50% in this scenario. Similarly, in this area also, if you do the same. So again, to conclude, when you have fixed duration on unit, no change in durations, resource must change. When you have fixed duration on unit time, no change in duration, resource must change. Fixed unit, then whatever you change in the units, based on the resource available and their productivity rate, the duration will change. And similarly, to fix unit time, when you have resource and you have limited resource, then the limited resource productivity, like having a machine in a location, you can't replace it with anything else. So you know they are fixed unit time productivity. This will define the final productivity per day and the final productivity for the whole period of this activity. I hope this explanation for duration type was beneficial to you and easy to understand. Thank you very much for watching and most welcome. Engineer Ziad Al-Basir, and please subscribe to follow us and to get the new projects when it comes. Thank you very much.